गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर 8th स्टैंडर्ड। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इंग्लिश मलबरी चैप्टर नंबर 1, द न्यू हाउस। दिस इज द स्टोरी ऑफ अ 9 ईयर्स ओल्ड बॉय नेम्ड ब्रूनो। ही वॉज वेरी सैड बिकॉज He had to leave his old house. So we study the chapter. Bruno, 9-year-old boy who had to leave his house in Berlin and move to a new house along with his parents. His 12-year-old sister Gretel and their house help Maria. Bruno's father, who was a commandant in Germany army during World War II, had been given transfer order, so the family moved to the new house. Now study the text. When he first saw the new house, Bruno's eyes opened wide. His mouth made the shape of an O and his arms stretched out at his sides. Everything about it seemed to be the exact opposite of their old home, and he could not believe that they were really going to live there. The house in Berlin had stood on a quiet street, and alongside it were a handful of other big houses like his own. It was always nice to look at them because they were almost the same as his house, but not quite. Other boys lived in them who he played with, if they were friends, or steered clear of if they were trouble. When Bruno reached to his new house, he was not happy to see his new house because it was totally opposite of his old house. Because near his old house, so many houses were there. They all were big as his own house. They were boys lived in those houses who he played with, if they were friends or not, or steered clear if they were trouble. That's why he was missing his time, which he passed there. But now, in the new house, he was not happy. No house was there, except only his own. The new house, however, stood all on its own in an empty, desolate place. According to him, it was a boring place. And there were no other houses anywhere to be seen. Only his house was there, which meant there would be no other family around and no other boy to play with, neither friends nor troubles. The house in Berlin was enormous, and even though he had lived there for 9 years, he was still able to find nooks and crannies that he had fully finished exploring it. He was telling that the house which they were having in Berlin, it was enormous, very big. Even he had lived there for 9 years. That's why he was having a sentimental touch with that. He was still able to find nooks and crannies. Nooks means to say nooks and crannies. We call them gaps among the bricks that he hadn't fully finished exploring yet. There were even whole rooms. It means sufficient room were there as father's office, which was out of bounds. It means no one allowed to go there. There was no exceptions for that. that he had barely been inside. Rarely he had seen that house, that room. However, the new house had only 3 floors, a top floor where all 3 bedrooms were and only 1 bathroom, a ground floor with a kitchen, a dining room and a new office for father, which he presumed had the same restriction as the old one. It means no one was allowed to enter in the office as it was an old house. And a basement where the house help slept. Means the new house having 3 floors. Top floor where 3 bedrooms were there and only 1 bathroom. Ground floor with a kitchen, a dining room and an office. And basement, it was the place for the help only, where usually help slept. It means servants. All around the house of Berlin were other streets of large house, and when you walked towards the center of town, there were always people strolling along and stopping to chat with each other or rushing around and saying they had no time to stop. He was remembering that moment when usually he saw the person in the street moving here and there, wandering here and there, and stopped to talk to each other on the way and telling that they were not having time to talk. They had 101 thing to do. There were shops with bright storefronts and fruit and vegetable stalls with big trays piled high with cabbage. In front of their old house, so many shops were there. Storefronts, bright storefronts they were having. Some are selling fruits, vegetables. So many big trays piled high with cabbage, carrots, cauliflowers and corn. Sometimes he liked to stand in front of that to close his eyes and breathe in their aroma, feeling his head grow dizzy with the mixed scent of sweetness and life. He enjoyed that fragrance, but there were no other streets around the new house. No one is strolling along or rushing around. Everywhere completely silence, and definitely no shop or fruits and vegetable stalls. Nothing was there. When he closed his eyes, everything around him just felt empty and cold. Cold means to say silent. As if he was in the loneliest place in the world. There was something about the new house that made Bruno think that no one ever laughed there, that there was nothing to laugh and nothing to be happy about. I think this was a bad idea, said Bruno a few hours after they arrived, while Maria was unpacking his suitcase upstairs. Maria was the only house help at the new house. Either there were 3 others who only ever spoke to each other in whispering voice. There was an old man too, who was old, was there to prepare the vegetable every day and wait on them at the dinner table, and who looked not only unhappy but also a little angry. I think the best thing to do would be to forget all about this and just go back home. We can chalk it up to experience. He added a phrase he had learned recently and was determined to use as often as possible. This time, Bruno was talking to himself that it was a bad idea. While Maria was unpacking his suitcase up his stairs when he was talking to himself. Only Maria was there to help them. While there were three more, but they never speak. Sometimes they speak to each other only in whispering voice. There was an old man too, who seemed not only unhappy, but also a little angry. He was there to prepare the vegetable. Usually, he was there to prepare the vegetable every day and wait on them at the dinner table. He was telling that the best thing to do would be to forget all about this and just go back home. It means he wanted to tell that we have to forget everything and we should move from the new house. We can chalk it up to experience. He added a phrase he learned recently and was determined to use as often as possible. To wear this mother smile. I have another phrase for you, she said. It is that we have to make the best of a bad situation. Mother told to Bruno, we should try to make good from the bad situation. Well, I don't know that we do, said Bruno. I think you should just tell to father that you have changed your mind. And well, if we have to stay here for the rest of the day and have dinner here this evening and sleep here tonight because we were all tired, then that's all right. But we should probably get up early in the morning if we were to make it back to Berlin by tea time tomorrow. Mother signed Bruno. Why don't you just go upstairs and help Maria unpack? She asked. But there was no point unpacking if we were only going to. Now he was telling, if by morning, tea time tomorrow morning, we are moving from there, then there is no need to unpacking the bags. Bruno, just do it, please, snapped mother. Now mother told him strictly, go and do, because apparently it was all right if she interrupted him, but it did not work the other way around. We are here, we have arrived, this is our home for the foreseeable future, and we just have to make the best of things. Do you understand me? Now she told him that you should try to understand, this is our new home and we had to stay here, that's why I try to make good from the bad things. He did not understand what foreseeable future means and told her so. Then mother told, it means that this is where we live now, Bruno, and that's an end to it. Now no more discussion on this matter. We had to stay here. Bruno could not understand how this had all come about. One day he was perfectly content playing at home with three best friends for life, sliding down banisters, trying to stand on his tiptoes to see right across Berlin, and now he was stuck here in this cold, nasty house where no one looked as if they could ever be cheerful again. He was not happy to hear this. Nothing he was having. Neither his friends, nor sliding, nor banisters. He was telling that this house was completely cold and nasty. It means boring. There was no one. He was thinking that no one looked as if they could ever be cheerful again. Bruno, I want you to go upstairs and unpack, and I want you to do it now, said mother in an unfriendly voice. Now hearing this, mother became angry and to make him silent, mother asked to Bruno to go upstairs and unpack the bags. And he knew that she meant business to be turned round and marched away without another word. On his floor, there were just four doors. Two on either side, facing each other, a door into his room, two doors, a door in Gretel's rooms, a door into mother and father's room, and a door into the bathroom. "This is not home, and it never will be," he muttered under his breath as he went through his own door to find all his clothes scattered on the bed and the boxes of toys and books not even unpacked yet. It was obvious that Maria did not have her priorities right. He was not in good mood, that's why he was telling so. "Mother sent me to help." Now he was telling to Maria that mother sent him to help her. Maria told him, pointed towards a big bag that contained all his socks and vest and underpants to bring. "If you sort that lot out, you could put them in the chest of drawers." Now she was telling to him that you can keep these things in the chest of the drawers. She said, pointing towards an ugly chest that stood across the room beside a mirror that was covered in dust. Means the drawer to which Maria was indicating to keep the things in that drawer. It was very dusty. But now Bruno, he was in the mood of thinking. Now he was asking to Maria, "What do you think of all this, Maria?" He asked after a long silence, because he had always liked Maria and felt as if she was one of the family. He never thought that he was a household or help of the house. "All what?" she asked. This he said as if it was the most obvious thing in the world. "Coming to a place like this, don't you think we have made a big mistake?" Bruno was asking her that we had made a big mistake to come here. "You are not thinking so." "That's not for me to say," said Maria. "Your mother has explained to you about your father's job." To hear this, Maria told, "This is not for me to say about this. Already, mother explained you about your father's job because of the job. We are here." "Oh, I am tired of hearing about father's job," said Bruno, interrupting her. "That's all we ever hear about, if you ask me. Father's job this and father's job that." "Well, if father's job means that we have to move away from our house and the sliding banisters and my three best friends for life, then I think father should think twice about his job, don't you?" Now Bruno was going to be very aggressive, in aggressive mood. He was telling, "I'm tired to hear about the father's job again and again. Father's job this, father's job that. Because of father's job, we have to suffer. So it means father should think twice about his job." "You are not thinking so?" asked to Maria. Just at that moment, there was a creak outside in the hallway, and Bruno looked up to see the door of mother and father's room opening slightly. He froze, unable to move for a moment. Mother was still downstairs, which meant the father was in there, and he might have heard everything that Bruno had just said. He watched the door, hardly daring to breathe, wondering whether father might come through it and take him downstairs for a serious talking to. When he was talking to Maria, he was telling that to Maria. Suddenly, just at that moment, there was a creak outside in the hallway. Bruno looked up. ही वॉज थिंकिंग दैट फादर वॉज आउटसाइड ऑफ द डोर एंड ही हर्ड एवरीथिंग वाइल मदर वॉज डाउन स्टेयर्स. मे बी फादर विल वुड स्कॉल्ड हिम, दैट्स वाई ही वॉज इन टेंशन. द डोर ओपन वाइडर एंड ब्रूनो स्टेप्ड बैक एज ए फिगर अपीयर, बट इट वॉज नॉट फादर. बट वेन सडनली द डोर ओपन वाइडर टू बी फियरफुल ऑफ फादर्स एंगर, ब्रूनो स्टेप्ड बैकवर्ड, बट द फिगर अपीयर विच वॉज नॉट द फिगर ऑफ हिज फादर. इट वॉज अ फिगर ऑफ ए यंगर मैन, not as tall as his father either, but he wore the same type of uniform, only without as many decorations on it. He was carrying a box in his hand and walking towards the staircases. Case, he gave Bruno a quick nod and continued on his way. Who was that? Asked Bruno. The young man had seemed so serious and busy that he assumed he must be someone very important. One of your father's soldiers, I suppose, said Maria. We shall get to know them in time. Now to see that young man, Bruno asked to Maria, who was he? He seemed so serious and busy that he assumed he must be someone very important. To hear this, Maria replied to Bruno, maybe he was one of your father's soldiers. We shall get to know them in time. I don't think I like him, said Bruno. Bruno told that he liked that figure. He was too serious. I don't even think there was going to be anyone to play with other than Gretel. And what fun is that after all? She was a hopeless case. Now Bruno was telling, I don't even think there was going to be anyone to play with other than Gretel. And what fun is that after all? She was a hopeless case. He felt as if he was about to cry again, but stopped himself. He looked around the room without lifting his eyes up from the ground, trying to see whether there was anything of interest to be found. This time he was in a very boring mood. He was near about to cry, but he controlled himself and started to search something interesting in the room. Suddenly his eyes caught something. Over in the corner of the room opposite the door, there was a window in the ceiling that stretched down into the wall. He walked slowly towards it, hoping that from here he might be able to see all the way back to Berlin and his house and the streets around it and the tables where the people sat and told each other hilarious stories. It means funny stories. Something he got for his interest. I think this chapter is clear to you, students. Thank you.